folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this beautiful thing is an Epiphone Jack Casady bass. Off the bat, I just want to remind you guys that I am not, in fact, Jack Casady. I haven't got his remarkable digits. I mean, people dedicate their entire lives to sounding like the legend that is Jack Casady. Jefferson Airplane, hot tuner. The dude's a legend with a very recognizable, unique bass tone. And this bass will get you pretty much there. It's very vintage Gibson inspired, this Jack Casady bass, and it's perfect for playing the stuff that he plays. However, it's also just a great rock and roll bass. I'm playing it with a pick in this video and it sounds utterly fantastic. I'll be talking you through the history of this bass, the specs, and then showing you how it sounds. Like I just mentioned, this bass's creation was inspired from vintage Gibson instruments, which are some of the best instruments on the planet. Jack Casady was known for playing his old 1972 Les Paul bass, which he got in the mid-80s from Manny's Music, I think, in New York, one of the most prestigious music stores in the world that isn't there anymore, unfortunately. He got that, and he used that bass to kind of sculpt his signature Jack Casady bass from Epiphone. Granted, it's not a Les Paul shape, but it's very much vintage-inspired. It's vintage in the way of tone as well, but that doesn't mean it's not versatile. This thing sounds remarkable when it's cranked just as much as it does when it's played nice and soft. So specs, it's a hollow body slash semi-hollow body guitar. So it is a hollow body, it's totally hollow, however there's a block under the bridge here. So you kind of get the best of both worlds, that beautiful resonance from a semi-hollow guitar, but the rigidity and the fact that the bridge is going to come out the body with the fact that there's a big piece of wood under here. Speaking of woods, laminated maple top, back and sides, so it's full maple construction, besides that mahogany block under the three-point bridge. Said bridge features four individual adjustable saddles too. Now let's talk about the colour. For this video, I thought I would use the ebony one because it's the classic tuxedo look. I think looks the sleekest, the stylish, and the sexiest, especially when slung down low, like how Jack Casady plays it. It's also available in a few other colors, the amazing new faded Pelham blue, and candy apple red, which has a really deep candy apple finish up top, but on the back and sides is like a beautiful vintage Gibson stained walnut vibe. It's also previously been available like, as a gold top and in white, all set off beautifully with the cream binding and the cream plastics, but you can't beat the ebony one. It's just so classic inspired, it's awesome. Moving up the neck, it's a mahogany neck, a very, very comfortable modern C mahogany neck, set neck, which just adds to the resonance of this whole thing. When something's this well put together and this solid and also this hollow, you get that beautiful vintage bass tone we all love. Up to the headstock, Jack Casady silkscreen logo, a clover open back gear tuners so you can see the mechanism on the back. Fingerboard is a 12-inch radius Indian Laurel fingerboard with beautiful trapezoid inlays, 20 medium jumbo frets. Now let's talk about the electronics. There's not really a lot going on for how much you can do with this bass. It features the JCB1 pickup, which is the Jack Casady bass 1 pickup, designed by Jack Casady back in the day to have a lot of warmth in the low end, but also a lot of poke as well, especially when paired with what is essentially a VariTone switch. But it's not really a VariTone switch in the sense that it alters the frequencies. It's more like an impedance switch. So there's three different tones you can have from your Jack Casady bass. Kind of like getting different settings in the studio and changing basses, but live you can do it with one bass. One volume and one tone too, gold speed knobs with a little thumb bleeder pointers on. The final specs, I will get into playing shortly, I promise. 34-inch scale, there's a faux bone nut up top, and the options on the impedance VariTone switch are 50, 250 and 500. I'll be using 500 to start with, and then going down the way. Two tech cables into the fabulous Blackstar Unity Bass U120 bass combo. I'm on the classic setting, all the EQ is at noon, the compression is off. This is how she sounds. Down to 50. There's quite a considerable drop in volume there, isn't there?
Mm-hmm.
Because it's double cut as well, you can get to the dusty end, no problem at all. That sounds beautiful. It's that lovely kind of robust, thick low end. I love guitar words. Yes, this bass amp has overdrive, and I want to see what it sounds like with overdrive. You've got to be in the room to feel this overall astounding resonance from this bass. The floor is shaking, there's offices upstairs, and I really hope they like distorted bass tone. Bass. That was on 50 as well, so full air 500. That was just my own benefit. I'm guessing a lot of people out there watching this video don't want to hear a Jack Casady bass absolute full throttle, but that's what it can do. It's such an amazing bass. Let me know down below in the comments which is your favorite finish, because they're all more beautiful than the last, and if you've ever played one, because they do play quite unique and they sound utterly fantastic. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on the Epiphone Jack Casady bass, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.